tuning into my channel. Make sure you like and subscribe to get all future videos. Right now I'm just showing my products. So we have some Milky White from Not Polished, Rhubarb Fizz, Glitter Mixed Acrylic from Glitter Bells. We have Gold Ether Flakes from Wave Gel. And I'm also going to be using Clear Acrylic from Young Nails, as well as their Monomer. And then, of course, my size 16 Creations by Kiki acrylic brush, which is my fave. I've already prepped her, and right now I am laying some No Lift primer right before I start my first bead. I'll be using Milky White first on her pointer finger and her pinkies. It kind of gets away from me a little bit, so I am kind of in the moment, kind of training myself and my brush to know how to get the bead the way I want to. Second bead by the cuticle, of course. You'll see I have a lot more control of my second bead. My first bead on my client's nails, depending on what acrylic and monomer I'm using, is always kind of a tester. So I'm just making sure I'm happy with her apex, her structure of her nails. I like all my nails to look a certain way. Going right to her pinky with the same color so I don't mix any glitter that I'll be using on her other coffin-shaped nails in this set. You're gonna see me mold my acrylic that I picked up more so than trying to do excess amount of layers. I have a thing about, you know, utilizing what you pick up. I basically have a picture of what I want her nails to look like in my mind, and I am making sure to attain this structure, this shape, this apex, all while I'm applying my acrylic and not after. Again, I like to work on top of wet primer, so I'm gonna reprime. And then we're going right into our thin acrylic layer, but right before I encapsulate anything for any encapsulation art ever. Then I'm gonna lay this Rhubarb Fizz, which is this chunky iridescent glitter. I'm picking it up in chunks, so I'm trying to lay it down as flat as possible because I know I want the second layer of design to be kind of depthy. I don't want it kind of mixing in. I want it to be kind of floating on top. So I'm gonna add another clear layer in between to give it that depth. And then I'm gonna come in with these Wave Gel Ether Flakes. They're kind of really super, super thin mylar. They'll crumble if you like rub your brush while you're laying, but I don't want them to, so I'm kind of just laying them straight up. Then I'm gonna encapsulate with another layer of clear. Now, between all these layers, they are thin, but I'm building the structure up with these clear acrylic layers. And towards the end, I'm putting my, make sure my apex is all the way together. If you look closely, you'll catch me kind of turning the nail sideways. I'm looking down the barrel of the nail. This is to make sure that my structure is the way that I need it to be. Just to show you guys how thin this layer of acrylic is, I will let it dry a little bit before I continued. And we're right back in the game with the Rhubarb Fizz. And like I said, you see me kind of spreading the glitter out, putting the glitter in places that I want to cover. For example, I don't like my client's natural nail plate to kind of show through my clearish, iridescentish kind of nail. So I'm moving the glitter on top of her where her free edge is showing, so it looks more like a glass nail. A few people who watch my videos or see my pictures end up asking me why I do the nails a little thicker than usual. I do my nails thicker because I'm giving myself, number one, room for error. Number two, I like my nails to look sculpted even though I use tips. So I kind of drill away the tip towards the end, which you'll see me do towards the end of this video as well. this right here is a good example of me covering free edge with glitter. As I'm doing this nail, you see I have it in a downward position. I'm kind of letting gravity help me out as far as pulling the product down to the tip of her nail because it's her thumb, so I have to use a little bit more product than I would on, let's say, her pinky. Switching to her other hand, you can tell, well, I can tell that I've become a lot more comfortable with the way that my acrylic and monomer are working together. So I'm wasting a lot less product than I was with that very first pointer finger on her other hand. I'm going so confident with the wrong acrylic color, so that was me. That was that. That happened. What I'm gonna do on this hand actually is the same design, but I'm gonna do it in a different order, if that makes sense. So I'm laying my clear first, and I'm gonna go back on both nails and put the glitter down, then the gold, then the clear, then the structure, and so on and so forth. So same goes as her other thumb. I have it held in a downward position to let gravity help me pull all that product down to the tip of her finger. Thank you. I don't really have a reason why I'm doing the layers of acrylic in this order. Maybe I thought, you know, it was gonna go quicker if I did it this way. Jumping straight into filing her shape, contouring her size. If you've been in one of my boot camps, you know what I'm talking about. I'm using Tammy Taylor's peel and stick file system in a 100 grit on both sides of my file. While I'm filing, I'm using the thumb that I'm holding her with on my left hand to basically give a quick feel. I'm kind of cross-checking myself to make sure that there's no like major bumps, lumps, or humps I need to remove or smooth. Something else I want to also note is that every step in my service makes the following step easier for me as the nail tech. So my prep makes it easier for me to apply my product. The way I apply my product makes it easier to file. The way I file makes it easier to drill, and so on and so forth. Jumping in automatically and adding that deep C curve in that I like my nails to have. Notice how I'm turning her finger, the direction and the angle of her finger and her hand as I'm drilling. This is why it's really important that my client relaxes at this point, because the way I'm using my drill is kind of like pencil to paper. I know exactly where I'm gonna write, when I'm gonna write it, but if they're not relaxed and they don't kind of let me direct it, then that's how, you know, clients get cut, and we don't wanna do that. We're coming up on the finish line of this set. At this point, I am buffing. Basically, I'm buffing in the same angle and direction that I was filing earlier. If you buff too hard, too rough, you can kind of mess up your structure. So just keep that in mind. And the buffer's from OPI. I'm using Shiny from King of Nail, Max Estrada, his no white top coat. I really like this top coat, it's very glossy. You're gonna see me double back on nails I've already top coated. And this is just me taking off the excess amount of top coat. It might not look like it because it's clear, but if you use too much top coat and don't, you know, cross check yourself and go back and make sure it's not like bubbling, then it can change your shape and make it more round. And I don't want that either. When I do glass nails as well, I top coat underneath the nail to bring that shine all the way through. I will say, make sure you don't have any dust underneath these nails before you cure them. You don't want to get any dust in your top coat. Here we have the finished look. She has cured her top coat. I've cuticle oiled her finger. She's sugar scrubbed her hands. And now we're ready for pictures. And can I just say, pat myself on the back, because this set is awesome. Thank you so much for watching my first voiceover tutorial. So please let me know how I did in the comments. Let me know what you want to see from me in the future. Like and subscribe, and follow me on my social media.